CLC family, today we're speaking about becoming best friends of God. God wants to be your best friend. Your relationship to God has many different aspects. God is your creator and maker, Lord and master, judge, redeemer, and father, savior, and much, much more. But the most shocking truth of this is, Almighty God yearns to be your best friend. Only a few people in the Old Testament had the privilege of being in a friendship with God. Moses and Abraham were called friends of God. David was called a man after God's own heart. And Job, Enoch and Noah had intimate friendship with God. But fear of God, not friendship, was more common in the Old Testament. Jesus then changed it when he paid for our sin on the cross. And like the Old Testament priests who had to spend hours preparing to meet him, we can now approach God at any time. The Bible says, now we rejoice in our wonderful new relationship with God, all because of what our Lord Jesus Christ has done for us in making us friends of God. Friendships with God is possible only because of the grace of God and the sacrifice of Jesus. All this is done by God, who through Christ changed us from enemies into friends. The old hymn says, what a friend we have in Jesus. But actually, God invites us to enjoy friendship and fellowship with all three persons of Trinity, our Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That God would want me for a close friend is hard to understand. But the Bible says, He is a God who is passionate about His relationship with me. God deeply desires that we know Him intimately. The Bible says, He made the entire human race and made the earth hospitable, with plenty of time and space for living so we could seek after God and not just grope around in the dark, but actually find Him. How do we become best friends of God? Through constant conversation. You will never grow a close relationship with God by just attending church once a week, or even having a daily quiet prayer, or a daily quiet time with God. Friendship with God is built by sharing all your life experiences with Him. Of course, it is important to establish the habit of a daily devotional time with God. But He wants more than an appointment in your schedule. He wants to be included in every activity, every conversation, every problem, and even every thought that you might have. You can carry on a continuous open-ended conversation with Him throughout the day. Talking with Him about whatever you are doing or thinking at that moment. Praying without ceasing means conversing with God while shopping, driving, working, performing on any everyday task. The classic book of learning how to develop a constant conversation with God is practicing the presence of God. The Bible tells us to pray all the time. How is it possible to do this? One way is to use brief prayers throughout the day. Like for instance, you are with me. I receive your grace. I depend on you. I want to know you. I belong to you. Pray it as often as possible so it is rooted deep in your heart. Just be sure that your motivate is to honor God and not to control Him. Through continuous meditation, a second way to establish a friendship with God is by thinking about His Word throughout your day. This is called meditation. And the Bible repeatedly urges us to meditate on who God is, what He has done, and what He has said. It is impossible to be God's friend apart from knowing what He said. You can't love God unless you know Him, and you can't know Him without knowing His Word. The Bible says God revealed Himself and Samuel to Samuel through His Word. The reason God considered Job and David His close friends was that they value His Word above everything else, and they thought about it constantly throughout the day. Job admitted, "I have treasured the word of His mouth more than my daily bread." David said, "Oh, how I love Your law. I meditate on it all day long. They are constantly in my thoughts. I cannot stop thinking about them." Friends share secrets, and God will share His secrets with you if you develop the habit of thinking about His Word throughout the day. I'm closing down with the Bible says, friendship with God is reserved for those who reverence Him. With them alone, He shares the secrets of His promise. May you have a God-blessed day today, and enjoy the rest of your week.